Hello friends, welcome to SS Unitech. My name is Sushil Singh and this is continuation of SQL Server interview questions and answers. So today we're going to discuss how we can apply conditional update in a single query. So if you haven't watched part 25 of this video series, so I would strongly recommend to watch that video where you can understand how we can apply row numbers. So let's start with our question. So this is your question. As you can see, we have two input tables. First table contains the information of employee. It has three columns. First is employee ID, second is employee name, and third is employee address. As we can see, employee address is blank, and we want to update this employee address from employee address change table. So our second table is employee address change table. As we can see, it has three columns. First is employee ID, second is employee address, and third is address change date. So we want to pick the maximum address change date from each employee and want to update in our employee table. As we can see, for employee ID 1, employee name is Howard. We have three rows in our employee address change table. First is Washington, second is New York, third is Chicago. And address change date is 12th of December 2013. Then 14th of March 2014, 16th of April 2016. So as we can see, 16th of April 2016 is the maximum address change date between these three. So address will be picked for this date and address is Chicago. So we want to update this Chicago in our employee address table. As we can see in our output table, employee ID 1, employee name Howard, and address is Chicago. When we talk about employee ID 2, employee name is Sandhya, and it also has two rows in our employee address change table. First is Delhi, second is Noida. Employee address change date for Delhi is 14th Jan 2015 and for Noida 18th Feb 2018. So 18th Feb 2018 is the maximum between these two. So address will be picked for this date and address is Noida. So Noida will be updated in our employee table. So how we can write a update statement to update the address column from employee table with the largest address change of all the employee from employee address change table with a single update statement? So let's move to SQL Server Management Studio. As I am using SQL 2014, you may have another version of SQL Server, but query would be same for all the versions. So now I am going to create the table. So first, employee table has been created successfully. Then I want to create employee address change table. So command completed successfully. So table has been created successfully. And now I wanna insert record on it. So four row affected. So data has been inserted in employee table. And then I wanna insert record on employee address change table. So seven row affected. And now we can select and check the record. First from employee table, so we are getting the data and employee address is blank for initial and we need to update this from employee address change table. So this is our employee address change table. So as we can see, we have same metadata as we can say in our slide. So now I want to copy and go to Excel to understand how we can write the code. So if we create one more column with the name of row number or anything else, and then we can do the partition on this employee ID. So this is our employee ID and we can do the partition. And then if we generate a serial number by which if the maximum entry date, then we need to 1, then 2, and then 3 in decreasing order. Then we can update our employee table very easily. So for employee 2, as we can see, this is our employee 2 and this is our the maximum, so should be 1 and then it should be 2. And for employee 3, as we can see, so this is our maximum, so it should be 1 and then 2. And if we can apply filter when row number is 1, then we can compare. So now we can see we are getting only three rows, and these three rows should be updated in our employee table if we can compare in our slide. So this is our slide. As we can see, Chicago, Noida. So Chicago, Noida and Manchester. So all these entries are available with a single employee ID. So now we can able to update our employee table. So how we can write the code to generate this row number? So go to SQL Server Management Studio. And here, first of all, we need to generate a row number. So I gonna use row number. This is our row number, and then over, and we want to do partition on the employee ID. So partition by, this is our partition by employee ID, and then we want to do order by this employee address change column in decreasing order, and we can put an alias with a row number. And now I am going to execute. So now we can compare. This is our the maximum address change rate for employee 1. So we are getting row ID 1. And this is our maximum for employee ID 2. So we are getting 1. And this is our maximum for ID 3. So we are getting row number 1. So now we can put this query in a derived table. So this is our derived table. And we want to update this employee table. So we need to write update statement. So first of all, we need to write update, then set, and then from this employee, as we can put an alias name with the A, and we want to update this A table. And what column we want to update? We want to update address column, from which we want to update from B table. And then we can see, and we need to put an alias name. Now we are able to get employee address. So where a dot employee ID should be equals to b dot employee ID. So, and now we need to apply only those rows where RW value should be 1. So it should be 1. And now we can execute this update statement. So three rows affected. And now we can select our employee table. So this is our employee table. As we can see, we are getting Chicago, Noida and Manchester. So go to our slide. This is our slide, and we are getting the same metadata as we can see over here by using this update statement. So this is our single update statement by which we can update our employee table. So I hope you have understood how we can update on conditional basis. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. If you need this script, it will be available on my Facebook page. You can copy from there. Thank you so much for watching.